الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. عباد الله، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله العظيم ولزوم طاعته، وأحذركم ونفسي من عصيانه ومخالفة أمره ونهيه، بقوله تعالى: فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره، ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا ومعلمنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله، وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، نبي بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حتى أتاه اليقين، فصلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين. أما بعد، brothers and sisters, it's one of the law of Allah and one of the sunnah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created mankind different, or they are all different. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have been or could have created mankind same copy. You could have seen 1 billion human being are all the same, but with his will subhanahu wa ta'ala and his sunnah and his wisdom, subhanahu wa ta'ala decided that people are going to be always different. And that's clearly stated in the Quran when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجَعَلَ النَّاسَ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَلَا يَزَالُونَ مُخْتَلِفِينَ وَلِذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if your Lord has will, He could have made human being all the same. One ummah, one nation. It means they have one same exact features and similarities. But His will is that to make them different. And for that He has created them. Because without these differences, without these non-similarities, people could have lived one style of life and don't need more than one direction to go. So life won't have that kind of diversity, and people won't look like people the way we know them nowadays. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His wisdom decided that we are different. And it's a fact that we have to accept. Now, differences. How do we react as Muslims to these differences when we see people different? So differences can be two different things. Either with something you have no actually choice with, your color, your height, being man or woman, where did you come from, when you are, the era you were existing in this world, these have you and do choices with. So you're reacting to it the way you should actually respond to this kind of differences. It has to be within the ahkam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is basically, I have no preference for that human being because he's dark or he's light or white. I have no preference for human being because he's tall or short, male or female. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will that this person has to look like this. So for me, my judgment on that human is according to what he's doing, not to the way he is. The other type of differences or difference is the way people think and the way people believe. How they have their own perspective for life. What they believe, what they want to believe in, what the way they want to live in. That kind of aqidah or belief or ideology, that the differences you should have an attitude for, but it's also controlled by the ahkam of Shara'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said clearly that when it comes to the aqa'id, to the ideology, to the way people are thinking, He said, that's up to them. لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَدِينُ It's for you, your belief, and for mine, my belief. And Allah made it even more clearly that no compulsion when it comes to aqidah, when it comes to deen, to religion. لَا إِكْرَاهَ فِي الدِّينِ So with that, I have to determine my relationship with the others according to the way they look or the way they believe. The way they look, it doesn't count in Islam. But the way they believe, it's also controlled by لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَدِينُ We have no right to force anyone because of his belief. Islam is looking at these differences as not only differences, also at features. Features. Islam wants you to understand that the fact is Allah made us different. And because we're different, that means we have different features. So if you happen to live in Canada, you know how to deal with the snow, and you know how to solve your economical problem, and how to feed yourself, how to live, how to build your house. But if you happen to live in South Africa, you have totally different environment, totally different problems to deal with, totally different way of life. So these differences people can learn from. So when I look at others, because they're different, I don't look at them because they are less than me or do I have any preference. No, I have to look at them that they have features that they have to learn with from. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it clearly in Islam, clearly in His book subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He said, Ya ayyuha an-nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila litaarafu. This word is amazing, it's so miraculous in the Arabic language because Allah did not say litaarafu, He said litaarafu, and I'll explain inshaAllah. Inna akramakum inda Allah aqaakum. Or you believe? O people, Ya ayyuha an-nas, Allah is talking to everyone by the way in the Quran. Allah did not only talk to the Muslimin, Allah did not talk only to the Arab. Allah spoke to everyone directly. Allah spoke to the people who even against the Muslims. Allah spoke to the Christians, spoke to the Jews, spoke to the idolaters, spoke to everyone and human being and to people in every different level. There's direct speech from Allah to everyone. Ya ayyuha an-nas, O people, we have created you from one single male and female. That's how it's the beginning. And made you all from this male and female into tribes and nations. So we are going to live whether we like it or not because this is the will of Allah. We are going to live in tribes and in nations, in societies, in countries. In totally different environments and totally different cultures and understandings for life. Why? Why, Ya Allah? Why just give us one place and we just go through it? Why into different nations and different tribes? He said, for one reason, He said, لِتَعَارَفُ There, if Allah has said, لِتَعَارَفُ it means I have to get to know you. Assalamu alaikum, how are you? My name is so and your name is so. This we know each other now. But ta'arafu with that double T, ta'arafu. Ta'arafu means to get to exchange knowledge. It's about the knowledge, ma'rifa, not just to know each other. So if I get to meet someone, we are nata'araf. Because we tata'araf, we know each other now, I know I recognize you, you recognize me. But when it comes to a level of nations and tribes and societies and countries and maybe civilizations, which is the most important thing, you need to get to know. So you exchange knowledge, exchange experiences. And that has happened along the history between all kinds of civilization and nations. And between practice, I need to indicate here that Islamic civilization, and you know me, I like almost to say Islamic civilization, because Islam is not only a religion, it's bigger than that. Islam was the only civilization that has connected the East with the West, between China and West of Europe. It was the only civilization in the human history that has connected East with West. So you see Chinese understanding sometimes happening in Spain. And this is, by the way, where the manufacture of paper came from. the first people ever to make and invent paper as paper were the Chinese. And they used to travel from China all the way to Spain to sell. So one of the ulama, I forgot his name, he was so curious, why would we have to actually buy it from China? So what he did, he actually kidnapped them, kind of. He put them inside and locked them up, saying, you're not leaving without teaching me how to make papers. In a place south of Barcelona in Spain. And still, if you go there, you will see the chimneys of the paper factories that what happened because of that scholar. He said, you're not leaving to China without teaching. And they taught him. And this is why it was so booming to make paper in Spain. So there's no one civilization like that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants ta'arafu, to get to know each other, to get to understand each other, to exchange, get to exchange knowledge and technologies with each other. So differences from the Islamic point of view is actually features. It's a benefit. It's a benefit. But if our job as Muslims is to actually go out and force everyone to become Muslim, this is out of your reach. And it's not your job to do that. You know why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also saying in the Quran, وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. None, most of people will not become Muslim the way you want it, ya Muhammad. Allah is talking to his messenger, Muhammad. Who is more than Muhammad was so keen that he wants everyone to go to Jannah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling him, وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ. Even if you eager, if you are keen that everyone has to be Muslim, it's not going to happen. Why? This is the sunnah of Allah. And this is people's choice, and the only one who's going to ask them about their choices is the one who gave them the right to choose, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, when people act toward you in a bad way, that's a different story. But we're talking about this level. Being human being, being different in our like materialistic look and in our belief, that's the sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the sunnah of Allah. So what happens, people sometimes who have enough ignorance to understand this fact, whoever he is, from Muslim or non-Muslims, get to the point that if I am not able to convince you, because the only way to actually interact civilization together is sit down and argue and talk and reason. If you look at the Quran that has been revealed in Mecca over 13 different years, upon Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was all about reasoning, about reasoning. They believe in something and Allah is giving the example. It's just to get your brain started to think. من خلق السماوات? Who created the heavens and the earth? Does any of your idols, these Aslam, any of them can create? Any of these people you believe they are superpower people can create even a fly? They can. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reasoning all the time in the Quran. Would it be better that you worship many idols or you worship one God? Which is better for you as a human being? Which is even more honorable for you? To create your Lord or create something your Lord has created? So it's all about reasoning. So when people get to the point they are lost the ability to convince, they start to be aggressive. So when people have started to have conflicts, either they are not able to be able to convince, or what they believe in is even not convincing. And that's exactly what happens. This is what they call sirar. It's a conflict. But the most important conflict is the ideological conflict. Why? Because this one, when one part starts to lose, they start to be more aggressive. If you look at two different people are negotiating about something, the weaker one is the one whose voice starts to rise up. And he starts to be more aggressive. The one who's so confident and is so much convincing and persuasive talk, he's always calm. And that applies to individuals and applies to nations. So when nation has lost ability to talk to Muslims and being convinced, they start to be more aggressive. And that's probably one example what you have seen in Quebec last week. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us as Muslimin through examples in the Quran how to deal with others. And it's amazing, the wording of Quran is so precise and so miraculous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and like he's showing, I don't want to just say, because when you read Quran, you're actually looking, you're watching. The story of the two friends in Surah Al-Kahf that you read every Friday. وَضْرِبْ لَهُمْ مَثَلًا مَثَلًا رَجُلَيْنِ جَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدِهِمَا جَنَّةً. Two friends, one of them was so rich, and Allah has given him gardens and rivers and so much money and so much kids and power, obviously. So the other friend, his other friend, was kind of just ordinary person. The one who has lots of money and lots of wealth, he was looking at what he has and he said, get to the point to say, you know what, I think I have everything, and I don't think even there's going to be day of judgment. Even if there's going to be of judgment, Allah will give me more because He likes me more. That's his understanding. He has everything. وَلَئِنْ رُدِدْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي لَأَجِدَنَّ خَيْرًا مِنْهَا مُنْقَلَبًا. I'm not going to lose. Allah treats me as the best. So listen to what Allah says when that man said the word of kufr, disbelieving. Allah says right away that his friend was listening because they're talking with each other. And Allah, what did he say? فَقَالَ, he said, لِصَاحِبِهِ, to his friend. وَهُوَ يُحَاوِلُ, why he is dialing, like he's a dialogue with him, while he's talking to him, while he's reasoning with him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is having these two different ends examples. One kafir, one Muslim, mu'min, and he calls them friends. فَقَالَ لِصَاحِبِهِ, and he was discussing with him. He was trying to argue with him, was trying to convince him. وَهُوَ يُحَاوِرُ. So why are we losing that privilege in our life? But you know what? You only lose that when you are less convinced. You only lose that when you are not able to convince. And that's very important. Very important that when you present Islam, you have to be able to convince. Now, if the idea is so strong, and the other one felt that his idea, his perspective is getting weaker and losing, he start to be aggressive. He started to be aggressive. So they call the wars, they call it Hiwar al-Banadir, the dialogue of guns. Because after all the materialistic actions actually refers to the ideological differences. So for us as Muslims, as individuals, as Muslims who want to present Islam, as Muslim who has a message in his life, as Muslim who knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has entitled him to deliver his message after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he knows that his ultimate aim is looking at al-Jannah, al-Akhirah. He wouldn't do anything that will displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even your intention is to deliver the message. So your message has to be delivered bil-hikmati wal-maw'idati al-hasana. Hikmah means knowledge. Al-maw'id al-hasan, to be in a nice way. Al-ilm wal-uslub, that's what you need. Hikmah wa maw'id al-hasana. So my point, brothers and sisters, today, that after what we have seen happen in Quebec the other day, and after that ignorant came and shot your brothers and the 5-6 of them passed away, if this person has enough knowledge and convincing talk that he had the courage to come and sit down and talk to these people, he could have had different attitude and said, just come and shoot them because of the politics he has in his mind. Now also, from this member, from this position, I also will have to admit, يجب أن يعرف الفضل لأهله. As Muslim, we always add value and admit if anyone does you a favor. We have to admit and value the reaction of the Canadian government, how they reacted to that incident, and how the Prime Minister did, how they all gathered together to show the diversity and the unity of Canada against any bad deed, regardless who is he and who is the one who was actually attacked. This is something we have to value, and we actually, here as Muslims, we look like, because most of us has run away from either political bad situation in our countries, economical bad situation like other countries, lately thousands of refugees came to Canada. You know how that looks like? In the seerah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he went to Al-Ta'if and asked for their help and their support to accommodate this deen and rise up and deliver it to everywhere, you know the reaction of people of Ta'if that time. And you know this whole story and what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his reaction was. So when he came back to Mecca, now, politically, he's not allowed to enter Mecca. You know why? Because he was actually going to have support against him. This is how they look at it. Abu Sufyan, Abu Jahl, this is how they looked at that. So he was not allowed, kind of, to enter Mecca. What he did? He went to someone called Mut'im ibn Adi. And this Mut'im ibn Adi was kafir. But ولكنه دخل في جواره. دخل مكة في جوار مطعم ابن عدي. It means he entered Mecca under the protection of Mut'im ibn Adi. So Mut'im ibn Adi as kafir, and he was just like every other one, but when he saw Muhammad, that's the nature of the Arab. Someone seeks help from you, you would stand, even if he killed your father, you would stand and help him because he is asking help from you. So when Rasulullah ﷺ entered Mecca, he ran to the house of Mut'im ibn Adi, knocked the door. He said, I just came from Al-Taif, I want to enter in your neighborhood, it means under your protection. في جواري مطعم بن عدي فدخل في جواري and he announced مطعم بن عدي ran to الكعبة and announced that Muhammad is under my protection, no one comes to him. We are في جواري Canada. We just enter in the protection of Canada here as Muslims. And we hope that this is a message to the Canadian government that every single Muslim here is in your protection and we want you to protect our musallas, our mosques, our communities, our organization from any Egypt can attempt such an attempt and attack our places. Why? Because we're Canadian citizens, we're contributing in this country and we love this country and we do value and appreciate their attitude and reaction to what happened in Quebec. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect every Muslim in this world and every sensible human being in this world and deliver, enable us to deliver the message in a nice way. It's our job. It's our duty. You're not here, brothers and sisters, to just make dunya. You're living here, but you're side up there because you're going home one day. You're going home and home is Jannah. So make sure you deliver the message. If you have to become an enemy for everyone who is different, then who are you going to deliver the message for? Your job is to deliver message, not to initiate any kind of hatred between you and anyone else. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to deliver this message. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله.
أستغفر الله.
الحمد لله المنعوت بصفات التنزيه والكمال وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الكبير المتعال وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله سبيل الخصال. عباد الله اتقوا الله فإنكم عليه تعرضون وأخلصوا له الأعمال فإنكم عليها محاسبون واعلموا أن الله قد صلى على نبيه في كتابه المكنون حيث قال وهو أصدق القائلين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. لبيك اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم لا تدع لنا في هذا اليوم ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا ضالا إلا هديته ولا مريضا إلا شفيته ولا مسافرا إلا بخير إلى أهله رددته ولا طالب علم إلا أنجحت مقاصده يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا هداة المهديين لا ضالين ولا مضلين. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم واقموا الصلاه ان الصلاه تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله اكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.